Hi, welcome to IT Online Trainings for you. This is a part 2 video of Azure DevOps CI/CD process in MuleSoft. Let's see, in this video we'll discuss how to create a build pipeline in Azure DevOps by using MuleSoft code. Okay, to do that I need to actually I would like to push some code to this feature branch. I have built a sample application in one of my previous videos. I have built this sample application. So let me commit this code to my feature branch here. Okay. So once we commit this code to the feature branch, whenever we raise a request from this feature branch to dev branch merge, we will build build pipeline, Azure build pipeline on top of this development branch. What it will do is whenever the code is committed to this development branch, my build pipeline will trigger and it will generate a jar, MuleSoft jar archive. Build pipeline is used to only create generate a jar archive by building a Maven build. So once the build pipeline generates this archive, then the release pipeline will pick up this jar file and it will get deployed to Cloud Hub, as we discussed in that diagram. Okay, so let's commit some code here. As I said, I have built this sample application. Let me copy this. I would like to use command prompt only to commit this code. Actually, we can use a couple of methods like source tree or e-git plugin and GitHub GUI. We have a lot of methods to commit the code into the Azure DevOps, but I am using command prompt only in this video. Okay. So this is our application actually. I have actually opened this application in workspace. Let me copy this entire code and let's paste my code here in this git directory which we have created yesterday. We have initiated this git, right? Okay, so let's go to git GUI, git bash here. So we will commit this code to our local repository, then we will commit this code to remote feature branch. Okay, first of all let me see what are the files available. So it is showing these are the files are untracked because I have added all these files just now. Whenever you see this green tick mark, it means like the code is up to date and the code is committed to the local branch and even the remote branch. Okay, let me add these files. All the new files which I have added, that files I need to add to my local repository. See, whenever you see this plus icon, it means like the files are getting added to our local repository. Okay. Now it has been added all these files to my local repository. Okay. So let's commit these files. To do that commit, we need to use git commit hyphen m. And we need to provide comments. I am actually giving initial code commit. If you can see, these files are getting added, so that's why it is moving to green tick mark. Okay, so it means like my files are getting added to my local repository, but still that is not there in my remote repository of feature branch. As we discussed in our earlier video, what we have to do, we need to push these changes to remote repository by using git push origin. Once you use this command, it will take the tabulated code from local repository and it will commit that push those changes to remote repository. You can see objects 20 done. So let's refresh this page and see. This is our Azure DevOps, if you remember. Here you can see all the code is getting committed to just now all the code is committed to this remote repository of feature branch. Okay, so now we are done. We have the code in our feature branch. We can commit, we can push this code, raise a pull request from this feature branch development branch later. For now, we have this code. So as we discussed in earlier, once any developer work on this feature branch, developer will commit the code to this feature branch. Then whenever he raise a pull request from this feature branch to development branch, once the code is committed to development branch, build pipeline will trigger. Okay, so let's stop this branches here. Let's start creating build pipeline. Okay, to do that you need to go to this Azure DevOps pipeline section. So this pipeline section is used for generating build pipelines, and this releases section is used for configuring release pipeline. For in Azure DevOps, we need to create two different pipelines in order to complete the CI/CD process. Okay, so first let's create build pipeline. So click on this pipelines. It will show you this create pipeline button. Click on it. Go to classic editor, and here this is the repository you need to select. Okay, it will support Azure repos Git, GitHub, as well as enterprise server, Subversion, Bitbucket, and other Git version. Okay, if you for now, actually I am using Azure DevOps Git only for my code commit and all. If you remember, I have this repos in my Azure DevOps only. I am actually committing my code to Azure DevOps Git itself. So I can select this Azure DevOps. If you are using a GitHub as your coding repository, you need to select this option. Okay, in my case, this is applicable to me. Okay, let's select the project name. As I have only one project, automatically it will pull up. And the repository we need to select here. In single project, we may have multiple repositories for each and every API. This is my demo system API which I have created. We may have different repositories, like one is for process API, one is for experience API, one is for other integrations. We have a couple of repositories. For each and every repository, we need to configure this build pipeline and release pipeline. You need to keep that in mind. Okay, then default branch for manual or scheduled builds. In this section, you need to select the branch. Here I would like to select development branch. As I discussed, once the code is committed to development branch, my build pipeline should trigger and it will generate the archive. That is my requirement. Okay, so I am selecting development branch here. Click on continue. Okay, here you need to select the template. Okay, for now, MuleSoft is using Maven as a build, Apache Maven is a build command and all. So you need to select this Maven template. If you are going to use Docker or any other applicable to other projects, they can select Docker container or ASP.NET and all. In our MuleSoft projects, we need to select this Maven template and click on apply. By default, it will generate a couple of steps. You can just remove that for now. We will add one by one. Okay. You need to remove these tasks because all the Maven template tasks are not applicable to us. So let's keep this mavenpom.xml task. What it will do is, like, it will select our pom.xml file. Okay, here by default, actually it will be configured with the pom.xml file. Just observe these options. We need to we'll discuss one by one options how we can configure. Okay, so display name we can give, by default it will come. Goals we need to modify as per our form.xml. Here you need to give goals like clean package and options like skip your minutes and attach mule sources. This is to actually to add all the dependencies. Okay, the remaining options actually you need to keep it as a default. And we need to add one more agent job. Actually, whenever our build pipeline will trigger, this agent job will initiate the process. Okay, so let me add one more task. That is nothing but you can just search for download secure file. See, this is the download secure file task. You need to add this. What this task will do is like it will take the settings.xml file of our Maven settings.xml file where we are actually configuring our AnyPoint Studio platform credentials. So here in this way, one server tag we need to add in your settings.xml page. This ID you can make it as exchange to this same would be available in your form.xml, and username, your cloud hub username and cloud hub password you need to give here, and you need to update this settings.xml file under this server section. You need to add this tag. Okay, make this settings.xml file ready. Let's go back to our Azure task. So here, while you configure this, you need to select the settings.xml file. Before that, you need to add that settings.xml file to here Azure DevOps library. Okay, let me add this. You need to, okay, or else if you can directly select it from here. Go to settings and here you can browse for that settings.xml file. Let me copy this. Okay, sorry. Let me go back to the here I have actually placed it, a settings start practice file. Open it. It will be automatically added to this Azure DevOps library. Okay, click on OK. So it will take up the settings.xml file. You can give it any other name, but you can just make it as a XML file, which is similar to this your Maven settings repository settings.xml file. So here, let's configure this reference name. We can add, we need to add this reference name in our next step. Okay, just give some name like secure file. This path we need to add some in another steps. So just remember this. Okay, now we are good. We have configured download secure file. Then what it will do is like for Maven, it will build the file. It will make the Cloud Hub credentials by using the settings.xml file. Then our next step is to publish this artifact to Azure DevOps workspace. Artifact is nothing but that jar file, MuleSoft executable jar file, which we need to deploy into Cloud Hub. Okay, so we have another task here. Yeah, publish pipeline artifacts. You can search for public pipeline artifact and you need to add this. And let's configure this. Okay, this is the workspace. And once the project archive is getting generated, it will add that archive to project workspace by default. Here you can actually leave it as it is for the default pipeline.workspace. It will generate the jar and it will store that jar file into this workspace. You can you need to give some artifact name like this, and you can rename this display name. Actually, we can rename this job name as well. Pipeline name also you can actually rename it. I'll give it as demo system API build, because this is build pipeline. Okay, till now we have configured a pom.xml maven task, a secure file and artifact. Then we need to add one more task, that is for munits. Munits also a maven task, so you can select a maven. You need to add one more maven task here. You need to rename it as munits. Okay, in options what you can do is like you can here you can give the goals like clean test and hyphen yes. This is a command actually we need to give, and we need to pass this secure file path which we have given alias name here, right? This reference name here, it will show you this variable path. You need to select this. You need to configure here. As a property, as a dynamic property, you need to configure here in this by using this syntax. Okay, now this options, under this options you can specify what are the different variables you have configured. Externalized variables, like what are the runtime properties you are going to give here. For now I have configured only environment property in my code, so I can pass that environment here. These variables actually we can send it from variables section. We'll go into discuss this. So in our code actually I have configured only this environment as a external runtime properties from CloudHub I need to give. So that is why I have configured only this. Some in case of encryption or any other runtime properties you are going to specify here, you can specify under these options. Okay, so now we are good. Let's save this pipeline. And we need to actually configure these variables also. So for now, let's save this. You can select any default path. Build pipeline, save it, and go to variables. You need to configure a couple of variables here. These are the predefined variables. We need to create one custom variable group just for our environment variables and client ID secret for that. Okay, under this you need to click on manage variable group. It will open another window. Here you need to actually add your variable group. You need to create one new variable group. Under that you need to add all your variables. Okay, let's name it as demo API build. Okay, demo system API variable group. Just for our understanding, I have named it as like this. And you need to add all the variables and values here. We need to give our environment client ID and client secret. And you need to give that environment value. I'm actually using the sandbox. I'll show you where to get these values. Okay. Yeah, you need to configure one more property like CloudHub profile. Here we need to give that environment name actually. So let's take these values from our AnyPoint platform. Let's log into your AnyPoint platform. Let me refresh this. Maybe the session expired. Okay, go to access management. Here, as this is my trial account, I have only two environments. One is design and one is sandbox. Okay, so in this access management, go to environments. Here you can see only two environments available by default. I would like to deploy my applications in sandbox environment. So if you can click on the sandbox environment, it will show you the client ID and client secret of this environment. You need to copy these values from here and you need to provide under variables here your environment ID secret. Okay, just copy client ID and client secret. And as we have seen, this is our environment name. Copy this. This is the environment variable we are going to send from runtime properties, as well as the Cloud Hub profile is also sandbox profile, because sandbox is my default environment. Okay, let's close this AnyPoint platform. And now we have already configured. If you don't want to show your client ID client secret, by using this lock symbol you can make it mask. Okay, now we are good. Let's save this variable group. Go back to your pipelines, build pipelines. See, this is why the build pipeline will actually getting added. We need to map this variable group to our build pipeline. So let's edit this pipeline. Okay. Yeah, and also one more thing you need to keep in mind. Here under pipeline section, you need to select your OS, your operating system. You need to select. By default, it is a Ubuntu. You need to select this as a your Windows system. Or VS. You can make it this default actually VS 2017. You can select this default one, or else you can select Windows 2019. For now, I am actually selecting this. Okay. So, we need to map that variable group here. By default, the values are getting generated here. We have created our variable group, right? Go to this variable group. Click on. We have created variable group using this manage variable groups. Now you need to link that. So click on link variable group. It will show you the group which we have created. Select it and click on link. See, here the variable group is getting added to your pipeline. Now it will show you what are the different variables we have created in that page. Nice. Now we are good. Then go to triggers. What this trigger will do is, like, here only we are actually going to configure our build pipeline is a manual scheduled or manual run or scheduled run. Okay, see here you will see this checkbox enable continuous integration. If you can enable this checkbox, what it will do, by default whenever the code is getting committed to your development environment, it will trigger this pipeline by default without manual intervention. If you didn't enable this continuous integration checkbox, what you have to do is, like, you need to manually trigger your build pipeline, but that is not what our requirement. Okay, so we need to just select this enable continuous integration checkbox in order to make this build pipeline run automatically. And the branch specification, by default it will take that development as we have configured this in our very first step of this in this one. Okay. Now we are good. You can ignore the other sections for now. We will see this later. Okay, let's save this details. I have added variable group and triggers. Okay, let's save your pipeline. Okay, now we are done with configuring build pipeline. So let's see how. See here, no runs yet. If you can actually select this and you can actually select this and run manually. Instead that, we can do this. Here no runs yet, right? Now we need to commit our code from this feature branch to development branch. Then let's see the build pipeline will trigger or not. Yeah, by using this run pipeline button, actually you can run this pipeline manually, but we don't want to run this pipeline manually, right? So let me, yeah, the code is in my feature branch. I have configured my build pipeline on top of development branch, right? Let me create a pull request to push the code from feature branch to development branch. To do that, you can go to this pull request. Click on new pull request. Here you need to select from feature branch to development branch. I would like to send the code. Okay, push changes to development branch. This is a command. You can give any other title for your pull request. So in general, in real time, what will happen is like the developers will add reviewers here. So as this is our testing purpose, I'm not adding any reviewers. Developers can add reviewers here. Once the reviewer will approve the PR, then actually the code commits will happen. So for now, let's leave all the blank, and you need to make sure from feature branch or development branch you are raising this pull request. Click on create. See, these are the different files actually you have committed. You can, for now, you can approve by yourself. You can self approve it and click on this complete. So here what will happen, once you click on complete, what it will do, it will actually merge the code from this feature branch to the development branch. Whenever the merge started, then our build pipeline also will start to run. Okay, click on complete merge. You can see here. See, I just refreshed the page. It is showing my demo, my build pipeline is started just now. You can click on it to verify the logs. See, this is in running. The process is running actually. I didn't run this pipeline manually. Okay. Once we complete that pull request and the code merge is completed to the development branch, which means like any single change is happening in the development branch, within seconds, my build pipeline will start run. And it will make all the dependencies, it will run the pipeline, then it will generate that jar file for my application. This is how build pipeline will work. Let's wait for all the green ticks here. Every step by step it is actually processing. You can check these logs from this console. Pom.xml step will take 2 more minutes. Okay, let's wait to complete all these steps. Once the steps are completed, then it will generate a jar file actually. Let me pause my video here. For the first time when I have run this pipeline, it actually thrown me an error. Two times it is getting failed. If you are facing any issues while running this build pipeline, what you have to do is like you can just recheck your syntax. Click on edit. And here you should make sure you need to include the skip unit test, because we don't have any unit tests now. And you need to make sure the settings.xml output variable. Here we are giving a reference name, right? You need to make sure this reference name is the same one which it is appearing here. This is the variable list we need to copy over here, this for this MUnit task. And here you should make sure the syntax. Here it is a dollar normal open braces and close braces. It is not like a flower braces. Okay, you should use normal open braces and close braces for this environment and this goals properties while configure. And one more thing you need to make sure while configuring these variables. And here for this client ID, client secret, you need to provide the organization client ID and client secret, not the environment client ID, client secret. And here, Cloud Hub profile, you need to maintain all the environment values by using small letters. everything should be in lower case. Okay, to get that organization client ID and client secret, you need to navigate to access management, click on organization, click on your organization name here. Here you will get this client ID, client secret, copy it from here, and then you need to provide those values for this client ID secret here in, under this variable group, and then save your variables. Now if you do any changes here in your code, now the pipeline will be the run will be succeeded. Okay, it took 11 minutes for me to succeed this pipeline, to complete this build pipeline. This is for the first time. It will take this much 11 minutes time. From next time onwards, it will take around 7 to 8 minutes for, to build your pipeline. See, earlier I got this error under M units. I got this error like the variables and security file, this is not available because I have given a wrong syntax earlier. Now I corrected it and I commit the code to this development branch again. So now my build pipeline got triggered and it got succeeded. So this is how Azure DevOps build pipeline will work. Here if you can see, all the jobs are getting successful with this green tick, and this one artifact is produced. This artifact is nothing but our MuleSoft application jar file that will be published to our project, Azure DevOps default workspace. Let's configure the release pipeline in our next part of the video, part 3 video. Now we'll make this link between this build pipeline and release pipeline to make continuous integration and continuous deployment. Thanks for watching our video. Please subscribe and share for more videos. Happy learning. Thank you.